session will be done by Dr. Ahsan Yahya, Lecturer of Medical Surgical Nursing, Faculty of Nursing, Cairo University. Can start.
I'd like to thank my professors for giving me the chance to be here. I also would like to thank Dr. Mervat for addressing this important topic about the caregiver, which I will talk about a little bit during my presentation. This is first of all, I would like to dedicate my presentation to my mom. She was metastatic breast cancer fighter. Her initial diagnosis was in 2008, and she passed away last April after 11 years. So, for 1 minute, I will say something that was not prepared, but it came up to my mind by Dr. Mervat's presentation. The caregiver, especially that point when she said that the caregiver is never prepared, which is totally true. I was never prepared, my family was never prepared from the first time diagnosis till the last minutes. Even when my mother went abroad for palliative care and there was social support for the caregiver, this was few months before she passed away, and my sister was taking psychological support for the caregiver. It's part of the team, and she was in a denial state. She refusing it completely because this care should start at the moment of initial diagnosis, because when it comes at the end, it's still in a denial state. And it should be professional. It should be professional because most of us, including me, we can call it like a social, a situational, emotional support. Like you can get support at the beginning of certain situation for your family or even for yourself for a health issue for like few months, but you will not get this sympathy for 11 years. You will get it for just like few months because people forget. I think I said it's including me, I'm not blaming anybody. So it should be professional support. So thank you so much, Dr. Mervat, for addressing this important issue we should all think about. My focal points in this presentation, of course, I have a small talk about the background of palliative care, principles of palliative care, evidence-based practice, and nursing implication. It will be discussed throughout the presentation, so we just concluded at the end with concluding point. So the palliative care is care given to improve quality of life. We all talk about the quality of life of patients who have a serious disease. It's not only for cancer patients, it's for any patient who have certain disease. Cancer is one of them, but any certain disease could have palliative care. The care that approaches the person as a whole, which is our first year studies. As a first year at Faculty of Nursing, we usually talk about the looking at the person as a whole. Its goal is to prevent, treat as early as possible the symptoms of this certain disease. Palliative care is also calling comfort care. It's comforting care for the patient, for the family, for the caregiver. So, what are the principles of palliative care? We will say why, when, and what. So, why this quote, add life to days, not days to life. I remember this quote very well. I have been studying it in the subject of sociology in the first year. I have taken the lesson, but I didn't learn it until later in my life, maybe in the last year. So we usually, and as a caregiver, we usually think, no, we want to add days to life. You are never accepting that if you are a caregiver, and even sometimes when you are working as a professional, you are never prepared to accept that this person is gonna pass away. Even when you are a nurse, sometimes you are taking care for a nurse, and when you are as a patient, when you are a nurse, taking care for a patient for a long time in diseases that requires long-term care, you have some intimacy with this patient, and you are also like the caregiver, you are not accepting that patient will pass away. So you are always thinking about adding days to life. You are never prepared for this. But we should learn how to add life to days. It has an impact on the quality of life for both patients, their carers, which is not always recognized by health professionals. So who gives the palliative care? The nurse is one of a team. The palliative care is a multidisciplinary team, including doctors, nurses, registered dietitians, pharmacists, chaplains, and the spiritual caregivers, psychologists, and social workers. They are working in conjunction with oncology care team for the cancer patient to guide the treatment for this patient. So when palliative care used in cancer care, there is a misconception, most of us have, I used to have this misconception that palliative care should start at a later stage of diagnosis, but no, the palliative care should start at initial point, at the time of diagnosis. We could start the palliative care to prepare the patient, the family, all the support system, and it makes a better quality of life for the patient and the carers and also the nurses. And here we are, that's why we are saying what is the difference between palliative care and hospice care. Hospice care is the one that starts a later time of diagnosis when there is no curative treatment. Our goal is to make the patient's life better, the family life better, to be prepared for this, but there is no curative treatment for this case. But in palliative, there is treatment, but it's taking longer. So, is there an evidence for the principles, the principle of palliative care? Yes, there is an evidence. There is a lot of researches. This is just a few summary of some researches, and there is a reference for it. And if anybody interested, I can give a lot of reference for this. So, researchers show that palliative care and its many components are beneficial to patient and family health and well-being. In recent years, some studies also have shown that integrating palliative care into patients' usual cancer care soon after diagnosis, as I have said, soon after diagnosis of advanced cancer can improve their quality of life and mood and may prolong survival. Also, the American Society of Clinical Oncology recommends that all patients with advanced cancer receive palliative care. So, what are the nursing implications? I didn't write any paragraphs in the nursing implication. I just put in this slide for you, and I'm taking you back and myself to the first year, our first lesson as a first year student in faculties of nursing, that we have addressed the human being. All aspects, the mind, the body, the soul, the social, the family, and everything. We should never concentrate just on the disease. So if you want to elaborate the nursing implication, just go to this and you will find a lot of implications and interventions to do with your patients. Finally, it's clear, when it's clear that there is no stopping cancer, heart failure, other conditions, not just cancer. We are here talking about oncology, but there are a lot of diseases that is life-threatening and requires long-term care. We should consider palliative care, which can help create a situation that maintains the quality of life and leads to good death. I don't know, when I put this slide and when I read this paragraph, I was thinking, what is a good death? But I wanted to remove this terminology. But then later on, when I think about it, I said, no, there is when you are at some point prepared, because you are never prepared. At some time you have support. Sometimes in you that you lived with your patient happily, and we lived, you saw him happily. And let me give you an example. I have saw myself in a private hospital. My mother was taken care of, and there was another patient in the next room, and they were just making the room dark. She was in end stage. The room is very dark, and nobody is talking to her. There was Quran going on, and it's like I felt like you are telling her, this patient die. You want you to die. Even if this patient is at end stage, and even if this is her last day, why make her like this? Why don't she was a female patient? Why don't we let her see the light? Let her be happy with the family. Let her be happy. She's still alive. Even if she is gonna die after a few minutes, she's still alive now. So palliative care focuses on both emotional and physical needs, makes relief of pain and suffering a top priority, provides active support to loved ones and the caregivers, and provides information about how to take care of someone at home. So that was all for this presentation. The reference, as I said, if anybody interested, this is just an example. I have a lot of reference regarding this issue. And I hope you find this presentation beneficial, and thank you for listening.